When we had that first enclave of the whole group, Mantan group, and we all discussed that yes, livelihoods is a very different kind of a paradigm, and therefore new courses need to be developed. It cannot be fitted into one of the standard courses. I had the opportunity to go through the various courses that has been submitted to the Mantan group. We have been collecting the variety of courses that we have done, and our Mantan members and some non-members also, and those have been compiled. Now, of course, the courses in detail will be talked to all of us by the respective representatives from various institutions, some universities, some institutions, and some actually practicing NGOs. But having overall looked at it, I think, you know, we have really made a substantial progress since 2013. 2013, when we had really talked about livelihood training program, there were just one or two small little hands that came up and we said, yeah, we are trying, it's the first round. But today we have a large plethora of subjects that are being offered in the livelihood curriculum. And that's all there with you in this book that has been just brought out. Broadly speaking, we can see that these have been categorized into four... Okay, the technology will continue. Okay, so these can be categorized into four categories that I have said. There are some courses which are talking about the basic livelihood context, the socio-political economy, the rural livelihood systems, and so on and so forth. So that's been one set of courses which are existing. The second set of courses which I find in the courses is courses about the livelihood perspective itself, where they have been trying to say that, okay, how is this practice different, or this perspective different from earlier perspectives of poverty alleviation or just employment generation? What is livelihoods? How is livelihood more important, etc., etc.? So that's the second set of courses that I see being offered by different institutions. Third set of courses that I see are more in terms of the methodologies. How to organize the people into their own community institutions, how to build them, etc., etc. So there is a series of courses that has come up in that area, especially in the formation of SHGs, formation of various kinds of producer organizations. So there are market surveys, there are courses of that kind. And the fourth set of courses, which I saw only in two places, one was that is about the field practice. Now that also brings me back to a very important concern, that though in the right in the inception itself we had said lot of livelihood learning will have to happen with an active collaboration with the field. In most of the curriculum, except that AUD curriculum, which is being done with the partnership of Pradhan, and there is also some of it in the TIS curriculum, where there is a livelihood practice lab, where there's hopefully they will be doing a lot of the field activities which they will bring back to the classroom, and there is a continuity there. Most other programs appear to be very focused on some classroom delivery of some of the themes, some of the topics. So though that has been talked about, it has not been really addressed in the courses that we have received. If there are any other courses, we would like to know more about them. How do we build in the field component? And possibly this is also because of our institutional structures. Very often our institutional curriculum structure doesn't permit us to involve too much of the field activity, and how do we bring it in? Very unlike the AUD, Ambedkar University, who have really devoted 2 semesters for field work. Most others are trying to fit it into the rest of it, weekly visit, once a week visit, kind of stuff, which hasn't really been worked out in so much detail. The second area, which is of course also of my concern, which I thought was quite missing in most of the curriculum, was this attitudinal issue. Though that has been also talked about by this morning by almost all the speakers, even in the last time we had said that is one very important component which we have to build in our curriculum. That is an area which I found quite missing in all the curriculums that have been submitted. Especially there was one issue which was raised last year, 2013, when I am talking about last year, 2013, where we had said that, you know, when a livelihood promoter is doing a very peculiar kind of a public service, but which has lots of features which are similar to a private service. You are looking at opportunities, you are looking at resource mobilization, you are looking like a quasi-entrepreneur. So if a quasi-entrepreneur who can mobilize resource and make money, instead of making money for himself, is to make money for somebody else, so-called the poor, then there has to be a serious component of self-exploration. They must ask themselves, why are we doing that? Now, that also I found was missing in any of the curriculum. None of the curriculum have really talked about a kind of a self-exploration or trying to figure out what their own attitudes are about the poor, what their own beliefs are, and so on and so forth. So that's again something which is missing. In terms of another area, which is the political action, that is again something which I thought was not adequately covered in any of the curriculum. Because again, livelihood literature today is showing that there is a lot of livelihood potentials which need to be unblocked only through political action and not through techno-managerial action. So, in that, if there are some courses which can be offered, on the understanding of the political reality, there are courses. You know, the socio-political background under which such things happen, the reasons of poverty, but converting that into something that people can do about it, there aren't any courses in that realm. That, of course, brings me to my last point. Now, though what I've talked about right now is a mix of all the curriculums put together, but none of the single curriculum is comprehensive enough to include all of them. There are courses which have been proposed by various management institutes which are very strong on the market mapping, finance, etc., etc., but they are not so strong on social background, political reality. There are some courses which are very strong on that side, but are not strong on how to count their money. Now, this also, of course, all to a great extent depends on the institution's own inherent competencies, own inherent biases, own inherent attitudes, etc., etc., etc. But recognizing that they need to be put together, I think the appeal of Manthan to all of us is that we have to put our hands together. Maybe we will have to start thinking of not only, now that this whole material has been developed by different institutions, so today that the course doesn't exist, material doesn't exist is no longer the situation. We have variety of material available in different places. And one thing which our Manthan team has started doing is to create an electronic database where all this will be accessible to all of us. So that is something which he will talk about in the evening. But it is not just the material, it's also the people. people who are good at teaching political action or social action. They win quite a few in TIS or institutions like that, XISS. But can they work hand in hand with people in institutions like SAIMB or IRMA? And can we have some programs which is done possibly with joint faculty from two different institutions, using materials of two different institutions, capabilities of different institutions, and bring them together for a rounded livelihood training process? That is something that we need to explore, and Manthan does provide us a platform for looking at some of those options. But one more question which raises, which I was troubled with when I was looking through all this curriculum. You know, this is still put into one kind of a paradigm, which is do some more training, which do some more organizing the people, link them to the market, give them finance, and life will become better for everybody. That seems to be the paradigm. All these courses seem to be revolving around that paradigm. Does that really improve poor people's livelihoods? I don't know. We don't know really. And possibly that's where my call to the researcher team will be, to also look at that, explore that. Yes, this is the paradigm. When we first time the Manthan group met, I think here only, Ashok Sarkar from that time Azim Premji University had raised a point that this is something which we have used in community development program 1951. We have used during Green Revolution. We have used during IRDP, etc., etc., etc. But still, we haven't cracked the problem. So I'm raising a research question, not just a curriculum question. I think this is something which we need to research on, looking at what more needs to be done, or can we really think beyond the box and come up with an alternate paradigm of livelihood promotion. Okay, so on that note, are we